Drogheda United trudge off the field after a 1-0 defeat by Bohemians, their 18th consecutive failure to win since their promotion to the Premier Division last year. But the story could be a lot worse. On July 25th last, while the rest of the world was going about its business, Drogheda United was in mortal danger when the club was put into liquidation.
It was really a combination of problems that brought about the liquidation. The main factor really was that in the First Division, gates are very small, in that visiting teams bring very few supporters with them, and there really isn't an appetite anymore for First Division football in Drogheda, because we're really up and down between the two divisions on a regular basis, and really it's the Premier League that people in this area want this club to be in every season.
On the Monday, the bank holiday Monday at the start of August, a lot of people have been away for the weekend, but over the weekend we spent a lot of time contacting people that we could, leaving messages. And on the Monday night we got 11 to 12 people to turn up at the Boyle Valley. A lot of soul searching went on about football in the town. Was it a viable to have a club in the Premier Division? And we felt, yes, it was possible, and it was right to continue, because we felt if it went then, it might be gone forever.
On the 7th of August, we had a meeting here in the club, which was attended by approximately 120 people, all of whom were interested in securing the future of Drogheda United Football Club. And from that meeting was established a management committee, which were given the task of putting together a team, a manager and a structure for the club for this current season, which would satisfy the National League and allow Drogheda United to compete in the league this season.
Amongst those at the meeting in the clubhouse were some of the founders and great stalwarts of the club.
The inspiration really towards the formation of a senior team came from the late father Kevin Connolly.
The late Father Connolly and his friend Jim Malone at Dundalk, he was chairman of the FAI that year, and he advised us, there's no way you get into Leinster Senior League Division 1. So we applied for Leinster Senior League and we were admitted to Leinster Senior League Division 2. We won the Leinster Senior League that year and we won the Polycarp Cup. The morning we won the Polycarp Cup in Talca Park, we won it, and we went over then to the League of Ireland meeting that evening after the match, and we waited in the hallway outside, and the teller came out and told us that we were accepted in with Sligo into the League of Ireland the following season.
About 2 months after when we were allowed into the League of Ireland, and we found a supporters club as chairman for the first 4 years. We had up to 20 to 30 members for the first few months, and it added on to that afterwards.
Our financial plans for the future, for this year and for the future, include the Patrons Club as an integral part of those plans. The idea was to try and recruit approximately 100, at least 100 this year in the first year, who would subscribe £250. They will in fact be the cornerstone to our viability now and in the future. We hold meetings 3 or 4 times a year, inform them of the day-to-day running of the club, listen to their views and plan for the future.
With an illustrious playing career behind him, Martin Lawler was given the unenviable task of becoming manager of the struggling team.
This was a new challenge to me to take over Drogheda United, and not only Drogheda United, but Drogheda United at possibly the lowest ebb that the club could reach. We're in a very unusual situation in that we're playing a lot of very, very good football, but we yet remain at the bottom of the league.
Former Aston Villa defender James Impey has been this season's success story.
I was delighted to bring James into the club. James is a young, he's 20 years of age. He's got a great career ahead of him. He was very, very unfortunate at Aston Villa. He got a wee knee injury. It took him a little bit longer to come back from the injury than normal, and hence they released him from the club. But I would like to feel that I've given James the opportunity to relaunch his career.
I think I was a little bit nervous coming here, and the players obviously thought, you know, someone from England coming over. And after a couple of games, you know, got to know that a bit better, and that, and we all get on really well now. So, well, I'm playing centre half now. I've obviously got a lot of height. I'm 6'4", so that's obviously going to help us at the back, because obviously there's a lot of heading and everything else. And they throw me forward for corners and free kicks, and I try and cause a few problems there as well. And, you know, just to basically when you bring new players, and it gives all the players a bit of a lift. And when you're playing well as a team, I think, as we are, I think, you know, our confidence is very high for a team which is like bottom of the league, and I think we can still do it, you know, if we keep battling and trying.
He goes well, he holds up.
Winning the FAI Youth Cup last season was proof that investment in an underage policy would service Drogheda United well.
3 years ago we had a meeting with the directors and the chairman of Drogheda United regarding developing the players from Drogheda Boys into Drogheda United. We agreed that they would take over our under-16s and 17s and set up a youth system of their own. This would give the boys, the Drogheda Boys players, 2 years to see, by playing in the League of Ireland, like a professional setup, what the requirements were for them to develop themselves and make it at least to the League of Ireland stage. With a local element, you're nurturing local players, and it's a great interest to the people in the town.
Since 1985, our fourth year entering the Dublin Skipper's League, we won our league that year and continued to win trophies every season since we entered the league. At the moment, we have that came through our club. We have the likes of Gary Kelly, who's playing with Leeds and he's a senior international. We've Nicky Colgan, who's with Chelsea. Gary Tallon, who's with Mansfield. Chris Winters, he's with Nottingham Forest.
Now you have a chance here with Don Tartan, and Don Tartan is in, and it's gone in the nets, and Drogheda have equalised. And the crowd has gone mad.
Well, it was absolutely brilliant for me and for the lads, the whole team. It was a brilliant day, it was very exciting. And for the club itself, it was about 30 years since the last time they won the U Cup. It just shows that that the club is progressing again with the youths that are coming up through.
And Don Taunton getting in once again. 2 in the semi-final, hopefully he can do it again today.
Yeah, we have a very big following. There's a few lads, but it's mostly girls.
We mightn't have won very much over the 34, 35 years. But one of the biggest achievements is to maintain seeing a football in the town for 35 years. I believe I can soar.